Get ready to match the stars. Gary Burghoff, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly. From The Price is Right, Holly Hallstrom, Dick Martin, and from Flo, George Bulifant, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
What do you say, partner? You ready to ride out of the range?
Ready to ride.
Okay. Let's say hello to our Aaron Durr and Charles Lewis over there. Now, Aaron Durr, would you briefly refresh our memories about you, where you're from and all that?
Okay, originally from Lewistown, Pennsylvania, and my husband Rick and I now live in West Covina.
All right. And Charles Lewis, we know you're originally from England, and you retired and moved here. Why did you move here?
I had a daughter here.
You have a daughter here. Oh, well, that's reason enough. We're in the middle of round two, and who's up here? Aaron. All right, Aaron, you want A or B?
B, I think.
Thank you very much. Okay. Did you hear that Ronald McDonald is doing a remake of a famous World War II movie? Did you hear that?
Oh, no. Hello.
It's called The Blanks of Navarone. Doing a remake of a famous World War II movie. His movie is called The Blanks of Navarone. All right, Aaron. Did you hear that Ronald McDonald is doing a remake of a famous World War II movie? His movie is called The Blanks of Navarone.
Hamburgers?
You know what the original movie was called?
No.
The Guns of Navarone?
Oh, yeah.
Remember that movie?
I forgot. Now I know.
Yes. Now you know what the correct answer an interesting answer would be. What do you say?
Aaron is from a foreign country.
Aaron is from a foreign country.
No, I said the buns of
Navarone. The buns of Navarone, certainly. Okay, let's just get on with it because nobody's going to say hamburgers.
The guns of Navarone.
All right, what do you got?
I think this is a match because this means hamburger. The Big Macs of Navarone.
The Big Macs.
That one.
Yeah. I got to match all three down here to stay in the game. Go ahead, Holly.
I got buns.
Buns. So that means Charles Lewis wins the game. What do you have?
Cinnamon buns.
Cinnamon buns and buns. Come on down, Charles. Cinnamon buns. Out of the blue dot, please. Now, Aaron, you'll be back a little bit later to play game number two, but right now we're going to spin you off, so hang on, and we'll see how we do here with Charles Lewis. Good luck to you, sir. We polled a studio audience not too long ago in this very room, a very nice, smart bunch like these here, and we said, write down your best answer to this. We said,
your best answer to.
Write down your best answer to this. Hey, there's nobody in there. Now, wait a minute. This has never happened before. Where's the door? It's on the other side? Where? Well, now, wait a minute. Come on. Get out here. Get out here. Get out here. Where have you been?
Hiding.
How come you're not in the box?
Because I'm afraid of you.
What's your name?
Robert.
Robert, you're on report.
Oh,
and if this happens again, we're going to throw you in a brig, right?
Yeah.
Right. Now, get back in that box. No food. No food for him now for 3 days. No water, no food, no bread, nothing. You hear that? Okay, let's carry on, shall we?
That ain't even the guy that works there.
That was the delivery boy from Mr. Pizza, just, you know, kind of happened.
All right, Robert, slide it. Afraid of blank. Afraid of blank. Now, if you give us the answer that audience wrote down most often, we'll give you $500. If you match your second most popular answer, we'll give you $250. And then if you match a third, we'll give you $100. Now, turn around here. Three of our six stars will suggest answers. They can help you here. But only call on the smart ones. The dumb ones aren't going to help you.
Brett, please.
Thank you. Afraid of the dark.
Yeah. There's one.
My name's St. Charles.
Hello, Charles. The Big Bad Wolf.
Who's afraid of the Big Bad Wolf?
And Holly.
Afraid of snakes.
Your shadow.
Afraid of snakes, afraid of the big bad wolf,
out there. Thank you very
and
much.
Afraid of the dark are the three they've given you. Now you have the option, Charles, of choosing one of those or giving us one of your own.
No, I'll take Afraid of the Big Bad Wolf.
Yay! Afraid of the Big Bad Wolf. All right, that was Charles Nelson Reilly's answer.
That's a good
stand
choice.
On the blue dot
also,
there now.
Also, afraid of
let's find
nothing.
Out if it's up there somewhere. We'll begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Afraid of your own shadow is a phrase I heard over there somewhere. Let's take a look at the next one, please. Big Bad Wolf is there. All right, now you got $250. What do you think is on top?
The dark.
The dark. You think that's going to be up there?
Could be, yes.
It could be. Slide it, Bob. Afraid of the dark. All right. So now you got $250. That means the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount, or $2,500. However, if you'll step up there and spin the wheel, and if it lands on a star, you'll double it and play for $5,000. Good luck to you. We'll root for a double. Go.
Let's double it.
Come on, double. That wheel is getting a little goofy. It went past for a second and rolled back a thousandth of an inch, and you got the double. And you are now...
God save the queen.
God save the queen. Gee, that's, we'll have to throw the question out, because the question was God save the blank, and now you've blown it. Yeah. All right, you are playing for $5,000, because you did indeed hit the double. Ready, my dear, here it is. Bamboo blank. Bamboo blank. All right, if you give us the answer that Joyce has on the card, you get $5,000. What do you say to that?
Bamboo hut.
Bamboo hut. Yes. Of course. I mean, having spent all of that time over there. All right, let's find out. Joyce, he said bamboo hut. What do you say?
I'm sorry, I haven't done well at all, and it makes me very sad. I said shoots.
Bamboo shoots. That's used in Chinese cookery, right? Bamboo shoots? Okay. There are others, too. What are some of the others?
I'm so sorry.
Bamboo curtain.
Bamboo pole.
Bamboo curtain.
Bamboo curtain.
Cane, right. All right, Charles, you have a total of $250, and that's not bad, and we'll come back to you in a moment or so, but right now we have this for you. Now we welcome back Aaron Durr, and if you're ready to carry on, are you ready to carry
on? Yes, I am.
Good, follow me, and we'll carry on. There. No, let's... Aaron, you may have A or B.
A, please.
A it is. There. A said. Mary said.
Yay.
Mary said. This has got to be the world's strangest town. Instead of manhole covers, they've got giant blanks. Round one question, it can be anything. Whatever comes to your mind.
I know I'm not
ready. You're not ready?
No.
Mary said this has got to be the world's strangest town. Instead of manhole covers, they've got giant blanks.
Waffle iron. I can think of that looks like a manhole cover.
Hmm.
Wrong, but interesting.
Your championship is safe. What do you say, Gary?
You have no idea how close we are. Both ridiculous, of course. I said Aunt Jemima blueberry pancakes.
Why not? A big Aunt Jemima blueberry, about so big, it'd cover it up there. What is Strange Town? That would be it.
Certainly, Dan. What about a humongous pizza?
All right, a pizza. Yeah, a big one. Great,
in honor
big
of
one.
Our makeup man, Nick.
Nick Scalacci.
Pepperini. Pepperoni.
You get nervous when you talk about
you
Nick, don't you?
Pepperini?
Yeah. Pepperoni pizza, he says, in honor of Nick Scalacci, whoever he is there. No, he's a wonderful makeup artist. He does me. You wouldn't believe I'm 112 years old.
Oh, yes, we would.
Shut up, you dingbat. Hello there, Holly.
Hi. Well, you know how upset I get when I don't match?
Yes.
Well, at least this time I matched a couple of the panel. But they have to be cheap pizzas, you know. It's really hard and crusty, so you can run over them. Yeah.
That's right.
Cheap pizzas.
Right. Cheap, El Cheapos.
Okay. Giant tiddlywink.
Tiddlywink!
Oh, yeah. I'm 105 years old.
That's right. Miss Joyce.
I said pancakes.
Pancakes. All right. Kind of a nonsensical question, but round one questions are that way very often. Yeah. Charles, this one is yours. Glenn the gardener said, I'm in real pain. That's what I get for crossing my legs with a blank in my pocket.
Real pain? That's what I get.
With a blank in my pocket. Glenn the gardener is speaking. All right, finished. Now we come to Charles Lewis. Glenn the gardener said, I'm in terrible pain, real pain, and that's what I get for crossing my legs with a blank in my pocket.
Secretaire.
A what?
Secretaire.
A secretary.
Secretaire. Pruning. Pruning secretaire. Pruning shears.
Well, pruning shears. Now, how do you say it in England?
Secretaire.
Secretaire. We don't have that word here.
Secretaire. You have now.
For my next act, I will place the microphone in one ear and it will come out the other. Watch it. So pruning shears in England are called secateurs. Secateurs. How do you spell that, Charles?
S-E-C-A-T-E-R-S.
All right. How would you like to make a contribution
secateur
here?
Secretary in...
It's a non-secretary.
What is that?
No, non-secretary is what he has in mind.
Secretary, yes, in Spanish is cactus.
Yeah. Cactus. All right. Pruning shears.
Pruning shears. What an unusual answer. Pruning shears.
There it is. Thank you, Charles.
Now, I really think this is a match, seriously, so please be nice and kind. I said hedge clippers.
Hedge clippers. No.
Pruning hedge clippers are...
Hold on, everyone. Quiet! Pruning shears are about so big, and you go like this.
Right.
Hedge clippers go like this.
Wait, Mr. Rayburn.
What?
Mr. Rayburn, it depends on what you're pruning, darling. If you're pruning a big limb off of a tree, you don't...
What pruning? You don't use pruning shears. You use a saw to prune a limb off a tree. Don't argue with me. I'm a gardener. Holly?
Oh, I missed by a long shot. I said, what was it if he had a hose in his pocket?
All right. All right.
This is
really
tonight.
Painful. A lawnmower.
Lawnmower. What do you got, Miss Dingbat?
I have a... Just a minute, I'll get it. I have a secretary.
Pruning chair.
Pruning chair.
Now, that's what I thought he said at first. I got a secretary in my pocket, and that's why I just couldn't understand. All right, Charles, you're ahead of your B.
A, please.
A it is. Brett, you do not play. Joyce, you do not play.
That's because I'm married.
Diane said it's tough being married to a football player. His idea of a good time is blanking me. Everybody ready down here? Holly, you ready?
I'm ready. Boy, am I ready. What is wrong with this thing? Ira keeps making flavor motions.
Holly is right. Yeah, her light is out. Everybody else ready?
Diane
said it's tough being married to a football player. His idea of a good time is blanking me.
Tackling me.
Tackling me. Tackling. Very good answer.
Wonderful answer, Charles.
What do we got?
Drop kicking.
Drop kicking. Charles, what do you got?
I said kicking.
Kicking.
I like that.
Well, it's football, isn't
very
it?
Very right. Hostile.
Holly, his idea of a good time is?
Scoring me.
Scoring. Oh. Well, she's got the right idea. Well, and she came to the right place.
Tackling.
Tackling, yeah. All right, you've got three. Now, Aaron, you need three to tie and four to win. Here we go. Nick said this town must be run by six-year-olds.
Why?
All the street signs are printed in blank. Yeah, cool it, audience.
Bum, bum, bum.
Nick said this town must be run by six-year-old kids. All the street signs are printed in...
Crayons.
Crayons! Okay, Gary.
Crayon.
There's one for you, scores 3-1.
Crayon.
At this moment, the score is tied 3-3. One more Crayola or crayon wins the game for Aaron. What have you got there?
Well, if I were six, I would write it in Crayola crayon.
Ah, that wins the game. What do you have? Charles, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
I'm glad you won some money. $250 there for Charles Lewis. Let's say goodbye. All right. Aaron. Here it is. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank token. $500 if you match the most popular answer. $250 for the second most popular. And $100 for the third. Now, let's turn around here and see who's going to give you a little assistance. Three of the six are permitted to help.
Gary?
Subway. Yeah!
Holly?
Bus.
Yeah! All right.
Joyce?
I'm going to go a different route. Love token.
Oh,
love
adorable.
Token.
Charming.
Here,
God, I hate a romantic.
What a rotten like answer. That.
Love token, bus token, subway token are the three they've given you. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own.
First thing I thought of was Subway.
Yeah. Subway?
Yeah. I've never ridden one, but I thought of it anyways.
You've never been on a Subway?
You well, haven't missed a thing.
Well, in some cities, they're wonderful. Toronto has got wonderful subways. England has great subways, or undergrounds, as we say over there. Yes. Now, let's see what we've got under the $100 response. Love token is up there. That's Joyce's answer. Let's take a look at the next one, please. Subway. All right, you've got it. Good.
I mean, should I feel smug now?
What do you think's under the big one, audience? Bus. All right, show us your bus token. You're right. Very good.
Good for you.
Now, Aaron, you've got $250. That means the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount, or $2,500. However, if you do spin the star wheel and get a lucky spin of it, you'll double it, and you will play for $5,000. So step up there and have a go at it, and we'll all keep our fingers crossed, root for a double. Go. Holly, it's going to be you.
Holly.
All right.
I believe you this time.
$2,500 here. Good luck to you. Here it is. Blank dump. Blank dump. D-U-M-P. Now, if you give us the answer that Holly has written on the card and put in the slot there, we give you $2,500. What do you say to this?
Garbage.
Some of you don't want to say garbage dump. What do you want to say?
City.
City dump. That seems to be the popular answer out there. But the important thing is what Holly has written on the card.
God, I hate pressure. But fortunately, I said garbage. Ah,
you have a grand total of $2,750. Congratulations to you. And now we've got this message for you. You've been splendid. This is the end of the week. It's the end of the week here.
End of the week?
Yeah, we have to say goodbye. Say goodbye, Dick.
Say goodbye, Dick.
Oh, all right. What do you have to say?
Goodbye.
All right. Watch Holly on The Price is Right.
Thank you.
Anybody else have anything?
Yes. Don't believe anything you read about me in the National Enquirer.
Well, don't read the National Enquirer.
Don't read the National Enquirer. That's exactly right. What would you like to say?
Don't read the National Enquirer.
All right.
What they say about Brett and I is absolutely not true, and I know it's upset Brett as much as it upset... as much as it upset Burt Reynolds and everyone else involved in this awful thing. As far as Bo Derek is concerned, it wasn't her fault.
Join us next time for the match game.
9 continued on 11.
Gene Raven, goodbye.
Today's consolation prizes are a cordless electric weed eater from Taylor Rental Centers. Taylor rents practically everything when you want it. Rent and save at Taylor. And a wok and La Choy Chinese food. Let your meals swing American with La Choy bean sprouts, vegetables, water chestnuts, bamboo shoots, and soy sauce. And 4 gallons of super scrubbable two-test easy care latex flat wall and trim finish, perfect for both walls and woodwork, sold only by True Value Hardware Stores. And a paper-made family of products, including freezer wraps to protect the foods you freeze, baking cups, coffee filters, and paper-made plastic cups for all occasions. And a selection of Castle and Cook products, including delicious Dole bananas, fresh and canned pineapple, fresh mushrooms, and bumblebee seafoods. And, like Mads the manicurist says, try mild Palmolive dishwashing liquid. Palmolive softens hands while you do dishes, and it makes loads of thick, long-lasting suds. And a bathroom scale, and Crystal Vantage for your bathroom cleans underwater, above the water, kills germs and deodorizes. Nothing out-cleans Crystal Vantage.